Your Honors, the last to be interviewed today is retired Judge Manuel De Jesus SIAYNGCO of the Regional Trial Court Branch 6, Malolos, Bulacan.
Okay. Judge, you may take your seat. Attorney Cayosa will now ask the questions.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Good afternoon, Judge SIAYNGCO. What is the proper way to pronounce your surname, sir?
SIAYNGCO po,
sir. SIAYNGCO. Okay, Judge SIAYNGCO. You indicated in your PDS that you are married. Is there any truth to the report that you sought an annulment of your marriage?
Oh, yes, Your Honor. There was an annulment proceeding which was finally decided by the Supreme Court, reversing the lower court's decision. And now, we're together again. My wife is here.
Thank you. You recently retired as an RTC judge, and after serving the court for 10 years, why did you decide to retire?
I was a judge for 6 years in the Municipal Trial Court of Malolos and 10 years and a half in the Regional Trial Court of Bulacan. I opted to take the benefit of early retirement at age 62. Well, honestly, because I stopped dreaming. I stopped dreaming of promotion to the Court of Appeals, to the Sandigan Bayan, after 6 attempts. And I felt I had done enough in the Regional Trial Court with regard to my docket, which was pegged at 640 cases when I came in June 2001. And when I left in December 2011, the docket of RTC Branch 6 Bulacan was 380. That means an average of, for the last 5 years I was there, I disposed of 700 cases out of 491 cases filed in that period of 5 years, as also indicated in the PDS.
Thank you, Judge. So why do you want to become Chief Justice?
In the first place, this was totally unexpected, ma'am, and I was surprised, completely surprised. In fact, I called up the, when I saw in the papers and heard on television my name being mentioned, I called up the JBC. Sabi ko, ano ba ito? Nakuryente ba kayo? Totoo ba ito? Kuryente is the word used by media for false information. Yes, it's true, sabi nila. And we have here a copy of the recommendation. We will send it to you via email. And then again, a group of former colleagues from my seminary days made a second endorsement. So I am dreaming again of entering the judiciary at a time when, after the impeachment proceedings and with the high expectations of the people of a reformed judiciary, I'm dreaming again.
Thank you, Judge. That was my last question. Good luck. Justice Peralta, thank you.
Attorney Mejia.
Thank you, Justice Peralta. Good afternoon, Judge SIAYNGCO. Judge, having been an MTC and an RTC judge for a significant period of time, if you are to articulate the common sentiments of lower court judges, what would those sentiments be?
Well, Your Honors, the RTC and MTC judges, we have taken offense and we take strong exception to the stereotype and often used term of hoodlums in robes. We know, for example, in the Regional Trial Court of Bulacan, that most of the judges there are straight, honest, efficient. So we take offense at this brand or stereotype of hoodlums in robes. Although we are aware that there are problems in the lower courts, the docket is sometimes unmanageable. The average time in the trial and disposition of cases lasts up to 5, 6, 7 years. The sentiment of the lower court judges is parang ano, by the way, in the seminars on personal security, which are being conducted by the Supreme Court, FILDJA, NBI, the first session is about statistics. Judge Ralph Lee gives statistics on the past 10 years, there have been 23 judges killed. The last one was Judge Arles of Bacolod Regional Trial Court. We know him to be honest and to be straight and to be efficient. So we are at the forefront, we are at the front lines of the judiciary, and we receive the brunt of threats, sometimes efforts at bribery, but we hold our ground. So the sentiment of lower court judges is, especially those who receive administrative cases left and right. I myself was a recipient of 7 administrative cases when I was in the municipal trial court for 6 years, all dismissed. The sentiment of the lower court judges is that it's somewhat unfair. There is not enough system of rewards and merit system that would encourage the lower court judges to aspire for higher position. That's it.
So, what significant achievement, if any, can you consider that has marked your judgeship?
Well, Your Honors, it is the fact that I have been consistent, regular in the performance of duty. As I mentioned, my docket was 640, and when I left, it was in the regional trial court, it was 380. That in itself may not be an extraordinary achievement, but I would like always to think that I've done my best. And like what I have been quoting in my blog sites and my retirement pieces in the site of XBD Philippines at multiply.com, the blog site where Father Jerry Orbos, Father Bel San Luis are doing their Sunday sermons. 2 Timothy chapter 4, verse 6-8. I have fought a good fight. I have run the race to the finish line. I have kept the faith. I have kept the faith of what I received, the training for 11 years in the seminary, the moral integrity founded on a deep spiritual formation which I received and which cannot be developed outright in the 4 or 5 years of the law school. That's it, Your Honor.
I understand, Judge, that you previously applied for the Sandigan Bayan and the Court of Appeals. So were you shortlisted in those?
No, I was not.
If you were not considered for those positions, what makes you think now that you will be considered for the Chief Justice position?
Well, the fact that I'm here, out of 70 in the long list, in the original list, there are now only 22. And I heard 2 have been disqualified for, so 20. It's an honor for me to be included in the 20 long list of candidates for the position of Chief Justice.
Thank you, Judge. That's my final question. Good luck po.
Thank you,
Justice Peralta.
Justice Lagman, please.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chair. I have read the statement, which is supposed to be your opening statement, which is given to us. This is the one? A 3-page statement.
Other is from the XPD Philippines, ma'am?
No. Ah, this is the paper which you submitted to the IBB.
Oh.
Yes. And I know Judge SIAYNGCO very well because we worked together when I was still an RTC judge in Bulacan. And with my personal knowledge of his character, he was a seminarian before, is it not?
Yes, Your Honor.
And I know him very well. I find no reason to further question him. And the fact that we have interviewed him several times when he was applying for the Court of Appeals and the Sandigan Bayan. Okay.
Thank you, Justice.
On that note, I don't have any more questions for Judge SIAYNGCO. Thank you.
Justice Hermosissima, sir.
Good afternoon, Judge.
Good afternoon, sir.
Well, we have interviewed Judge SIAYNGCO quite extensively before when he applied for Sandigan Bayan and the Court of Appeals. So we keep our record straight, and so thank you very much.
Thank you, Your Honor.
Secretary Mosgi?
I have no questions for the aspirant. Thank you, Your Honor.
Okay, just few questions, Judge. When did you retire, Judge?
I retired, Your Honor, in December, as of December 31, 2011.
You were, how old were you? 62,
yes, Your
Honor. So it's an optional retirement?
Optional retirement.
After probably passage of the new law, granting a shorter period of time in order to be entitled to default benefits?
Yes, Your Honor.
You waited for that probably?
Yes, Your Honor.
The other reason is that by retiring from the RTC, you cannot apply to the position of Chief Justice because you are now considered as an outsider.
Well,
is my impression correct?
I was not really thinking of that, sir.
Because
when I retired, I just wanted to enjoy the fruits of my labor, which, by the way, I have not. It's been 7 months since my date of retirement, and my papers are still being processed.
Mm. Mm?
No benefits yet. I'm now living the vow of poverty, which I took when I was a novice of the missionaries of the Divine Word.
But probably God is telling you to go back to the seminary.
Well, when I received the information from JBC, I consulted my former classmate and rector from who is now the parish priest of Kamuning Sacred Heart Parish, Father Linus Negacio, and he said, how would you know if it's God's will for you if you will not try? So I do not want to disappoint those people, my former colleagues from my seminary days.
Yeah, because I remember Chief Justice Fernan, no? I think he had a judge at that time, an RTC judge at that time, who retired and then became a priest. Yeah, there was one.
I can now no longer become a priest and go back to my first love because my second love is here.
Oh, I'm sorry.
My wife is here.
I'm sorry. So my other question is, do you have an edge against the other, over the other applicants? Do you have an edge over the other applicants, whether insider or outsider, Judge?
I would like to believe, Your Honor, that my background, my spiritual foundations, my being or having been a judge of a lower court gives me, well, not really an edge or an advantage, but a certain viewpoint of having a heart. But by the way, it's not only moral integrity, probity, competence, and independence that should be the characteristics of the next Chief Justice. He should also have a heart that bleeds with the miseries of our people and rejoices with their victories and their struggle for justice. Mm-hmm. I do believe I have that from my experience as a lower court judge.
Okay, on that note, I will not anymore ask more questions. Okay. Your excuse.
Thank you.
Now, we will start at 9 o'clock tomorrow with two nominees in the morning and two nominees in the afternoon. With that, session today is adjourned.
Speaks with the country's top CEOs.
There was an announcement that SMBC was cutting prices. Some people thought there was an earthquake.
To me, if we have to do it again, we'll do it again.
My conviction is there's nothing wrong with the business as such. It's the way you manage it, the way you structure the governance and the regulations.
With the most credible analysts and experts.
The market right now is very conducive for businessmen to lock in cheap funding.
The one thing interesting about the Philippines is that for once we are part of an anti-crisis solution for many multinationals. Cut costs without cutting productivity.
With industry leaders and government officials.
My belief is every business is a cloud business. So if you're not making this transition now, a competitor is.
The DSP can assure the market that if and when necessary, peso and dollar liquidity will be provided. I think that's the responsibility of the Banco Central.
To provide the most credible news and information about business nightly. Mondays to Fridays, 9 p.m. only on ANC. The ABS-CBN News Channel. The day's headlines.
The government is ready to evacuate Filipinos from South Sudan.
As authorities are also bent on demolishing the homes and ball mills in the danger zones.
The most relevant issues.
The House of Representatives denies a PCIJ report that the majority of lawmakers have not filed their SALMs.
The World Bank takes exception to what it sees as a misuse of a $21 million loan.
News and information that you need to know.
16 are arrested and over 20 are hurt during a demolition of shanties in San Juan.
A technical malversation case could soon add to the list of charges against former President Gloria Arroyo.
Objective, accurate, comprehensive. The biggest events deserve to be on primetime news. With prime anchors Tony Velasquez and Carmina Constantino, this is Primetime on ANC. Weeknights at 8, only on ANC, the ABS-CBN News Channel.
The biggest headline.
Up to the minute update.
The news as it develops.
I'm Bernadette Zambrano.
I'm Cody Velasquez. This is Top Story.
Weekdays, 5 p.m.
On ANC, the ABS-CBN News Channel.
Sometimes, it's about daring. And challenging the impossible. Sometimes, it's about losing yourself. And finding a different perspective. And sometimes, it's really just about hanging out with friends. And being a kid all over again. Come travel with me.
Executive Class, Sundays at 8 and 10:30 p.m. on ANC.
President Arroyo gains temporary freedom after posting a 1 million peso bail for election sabotage charges. The Commission on Elections plans to file a motion for reconsideration on the granting of bail to former President Arroyo.
The Judicial and Bar Council is